हेलो एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 12 ऑफ द कोर्स रिन्यूएबल एंड अल्टरनेटिव एनर्जी सोर्सेज। एंड इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एनवायरमेंटल इम्पैक्ट्स एंड द चैलेंजेस दैट आर बीइंग फेस्ड बाय द रिन्यूएबल एंड अल्टरनेटिव एनर्जी सोर्सेज। सो इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस about the impacts of solar energy and solar power plants that are being used to produce energy. The solar power plants or the solar concentration plants or the solar panels, photovoltaic cells that use directly sunlight to produce electricity, they do not produce air or water pollution or greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide and nitrogen oxides that are associated with the combustion of fossil fuel based fuels during its operation. So they are considered to be green sources of energy. However, the toxic materials and chemicals are used to make the solar cells, and those chemicals are very dangerous fluids that use heat to transfer in solar and thermal systems. The primary material that is being used in solar cells, which are widely available in our market today, are silicon. And silicon material, silicon is basically most widely used, which is basically derived from quartz. One of the most toxic chemicals created as a byproduct of the process which is being used today to create a solar panel is silicon tetrachloride. Silicon tetrachloride, when it is exposed to water or moisture, it releases hydrochloric acid, HCl, and when it is disposed of in soil, it causes acidification of soil as a result of emission as toxic fumes. And hydrochloric acid, when mixed with soil, it changes its pH levels. The problem can be resolved, however, by using the right type of recycling facilities, but recycling facilities are quite expensive. Also, clearing of land for the construction and the placement of solar power plants is quite an issue, as the concentration for the power density is quite low for these types of systems like solar cells or photovoltaic cell. So large areas have to be cleared for the construction and placement of solar plants. Also, they require water for cleaning of solar collectors and concentration for cooling turbines and generators, which may affect the ecosystem depending upon the water sources that are currently available. According to GreenPlace, the Chinese Renewable Energy Industry Association, about two-thirds of the country's solar manufacturing firms are failing to meet the natural standards of environmental protection and energy consumption. The production of polysilicon and silicon wafers, mostly known as the solar cells or solar panels, creates dangerous byproducts which I mentioned earlier, including silicon tetrachloride and hydrofluoric acid, which are being discharged into the environment after inadequate waste treatment. For example, in 2011, fluoride concentration in the rivers of main river of China in Haining City, eastern China, the concentration levels were more than 10 times higher than they were permitted according to the laws and regulations, which killed about many fish in the river, raising concerns about the human health. Another source of population is the careless disposable of used solar panel equipment, which includes the batteries. The batteries contains lead, cadmium, antimony, and sulfuric acid. These all led to huge environmental pollution. So, if improved waste treatment and environmental monitoring and educational education about the environmental pollution is done properly, the undesirable impacts and that are related to geological and environmental pollution can be avoided. Also, the concentrated beams of the solar power tower can be hazardous and kill birds and insects in the area in which the solar power towers are installed. This is the example of a photovoltaic array for marine crops air ground combat center in 29 Palms, that is located in California. So large amount of waste will be produced in the production of the solar cell, and also large areas are required to install these solar panels.